Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. Depending on where you are in this world, God bless you. This is Gloria White coming to you from Utah, USA. Today we're continuing in the book of Jasher, and we are in chapter 81. And the children of Israel journeyed from Ramesses to Succoth, about 600,000 men on foot, besides the little ones and their wives. Also a mixed multitude went up with them, and the flocks and herds, even much cattle. And the sojourning of the children of Israel, who dwelt in the land of Egypt in hard labor, was 210 years. And at the end of the 210 years, the Lord brought out the children of Israel from Egypt with a strong hand. And the children of Israel traveled from Egypt, and from Goshen, and from Ramesses, and encamped in Succoth on the 15th day of the first month. And the Egyptians buried all their firstborn, whom the Lord had smitten. And all the Egyptians buried their slain for 3 days. And the children of Israel traveled from Succoth and encamped in Etham, at the end of the wilderness. And on the 3rd day all the Egyptians had buried their firstborn. Many men rose up from Egypt and went after Israel to make them return to Egypt, for they repented that they had sent the Israelites away from their servitude. And one man said to his neighbor, "Surely Moses and Aaron spoke to Pharaoh, saying, 'We will go a 3 days' journey in the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God. Now, therefore, let us rise up early in the morning and cause them to return. And it will be that if they will return with us to Egypt to their masters, then we will know that there is faith in them. But if they will not return, then we will fight with them and make them come back with great power and a strong hand.' And all the nobles of Pharaoh rose up in the morning, and with them about 700,000 men. And they went out from Egypt on that day, and came to the place where the children of Israel were. And all the Egyptians saw, and behold, Moses and Aaron and all the children of Israel were sitting before Pi-hahiroth, eating and drinking, and celebrating the feast of the Lord. And all the Egyptians said to the children of Israel, 'Surely you said, "We will go on a journey for 3 days in the wilderness and sacrifice to our God and return." Now therefore this day makes 5 days since you went. Why do you not return to your masters?' And Moses and Aaron answered them, saying, "Because the Lord our God has testified to us, saying, 'You will never return to Egypt, but we will journey ourselves to a land flowing with milk and honey, as the Lord our God had sworn to our ancestors to give to us.' And when the nobles of Egypt saw that the children of Israel did not hearken to them to return to Egypt, they girded themselves to fight with Israel. And the Lord strengthened the hearts of the children of Israel over the Egyptians, that they gave them a severe beating, and the battle was sore upon the Egyptians. And all the Egyptians fled from before the children of Israel, for many of them perished by the hand of Israel. And the nobles of Pharaoh went to Egypt and told Pharaoh, saying, 'The children of Israel have fled and will no more return to Egypt.' And in this manner did Moses and Aaron speak to us. And Pharaoh heard this thing in his heart, and the hearts of all his subjects were turned against Israel. And they repented that they had sent Israel. And all the Egyptians advised Pharaoh to pursue the children of Israel, to make them to come back to their burdens. And they said each man to his brother, 'What is this which we have done, that we have sent Israel from our servitude?' And the Lord strengthened the hearts of all the Egyptians to pursue the Israelites, for the Lord desired to overthrow the Egyptians in the Red Sea. And Pharaoh rose up and harnessed his chariot, and he ordered all the Egyptians to assemble. Not one man was left excepting the little ones and the women. And all the Egyptians went out with Pharaoh to pursue the children of Israel, and the camp of Egypt was an exceedingly large and heavy camp, about 100,000 men. And the whole of the camp went and pursued the children of Israel to bring them back to Egypt. And they reached them encamping by the Red Sea. And the children of Israel lifted up their eyes and beheld all the Egyptians pursuing them. And the children of Israel were greatly afraid of them, and the children of Israel cried to the Lord. And on account of the Egyptians, the children of Israel divided themselves in four divisions, and they were divided in their opinions, for they were afraid of the Egyptians. And Moses spoke to each of them. The first division was the children of Reuben, Simeon, and Issachar, and they resolved to cast themselves into the sea, for they were exceedingly afraid of the Egyptians. And Moses said to them, "Fear not, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will effect this day for you." The second division was the children of Zebulun, Benjamin, and Naphtali, and they resolved to go back to Egypt with the Egyptians. And Moses said to them, "Fear not, for you have seen the Egyptians this day, so will you see them no more forever." The third division of the children was Judah and Joseph, and they resolved to go to meet the Egyptians to fight with them. And Moses said to them, "Stand still in your places, for the Lord will fight for you, and you will remain silent." And the fourth division was the children of Levi, Gad, and Asher, and they resolved to go into the midst of the Egyptians to confound them. And Moses said to them, "Remain in your stations and fear not. Only call unto the Lord that he may save you out of their hands." After this, Moses rose up from the midst of the people, and he prayed to the Lord and said, "O Lord God of the whole earth, save now your people whom you did bring out from Egypt, and let not the Egyptians boast that power and might are theirs." So the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry unto me? Speak to the children of Israel, that they will proceed, and you will stretch out your rod upon the sea and divide it, and the children of Israel will pass through it." And Moses did so, and lifted up his rod upon the sea and divided it. And the waters of the sea were divided into 12 parts. And the children of Israel passed through on foot, with shoes, as a man would through a prepared road. And the Lord manifested to the children of Israel his wonders in Egypt and in the sea by the hand of Moses and Aaron. And when the children of Israel had entered the sea, the Egyptians came after them. And the waters of the sea resumed upon them, and they all sank in the water. And not one man was left excepting Pharaoh, who gave thanks to the Lord and believed in him. And therefore the Lord did not cause him to perish at that time with the Egyptians. And the Lord ordered an angel to take him from among the Egyptians, who cast him upon the land of Nineveh, and he reigned over it for a long time. And on that day the Lord saved Israel from the hand of Egypt, and all the children of Israel saw that the Egyptians had perished, and they beheld the great hand of the Lord in what he had performed in Egypt and in the sea. Then sang Moses and the children of Israel this song unto the Lord on the day when the Lord caused the Egyptians to fall before them. And all Israel sang in concert, saying, "I will sing to the Lord, for he is greatly exalted. The horse and his rider has he cast into the sea. Behold, it is written in the book of the law of God." After this, the children of Israel proceeded on their journey and encamped in Merah. And the Lord gave to the children of Israel statutes and judgments in that place, in Marah. And the Lord commanded the children of Israel to walk in all his ways and to serve him. And they journeyed from Merah and came to Elam. And in Elam were 12 springs of water and 70 date trees. And the children encamped there by the waters. And they journeyed from Elam and came to the wilderness of Sin, on the 15th day of the second month after their departure from Egypt. At that time the Lord gave the manna to the children of Israel to eat, and the Lord caused food to rain from heaven for the children of Israel day by day. And the children of Israel ate the manna for 40 years, all the days that they were in the wilderness, until they came to the land of Canaan to possess it. Excuse me one second. Verse 50, And they proceeded from the wilderness of Sin and encamped in Alush. And they proceeded from Alush and encamped in Rephidim. And when the children of Israel were in Rephidim, Amalek, the son of Eliphaz, the son of Esau, the brother of Zepho, came to fight with Israel. And he brought with him 801,000 men, magicians and conjurers, and he prepared for battle with Israel in Rephidim. And they carried on a great and severe battle against Israel. And the Lord delivered Amalek and his people into the hand of Moses and the children of Israel, and into the hand of Joshua, the son of Nun, the Ephorite, the servant of Moses. And the children of Israel smote Amalek and his people at the edge of the sword. But the battle was very sore upon the children of Israel. And the Lord said to Moses, "Write this thing as a memorial for you in a book, and place it in the hand of Joshua, the son of Nun, your servant, and you will command the children of Israel, saying, 'When you will come to the land of Canaan, you will utterly efface the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven.'" And Moses did so, and took the book and wrote upon it these words, saying, "Remember what Amalek has done to you in the road when you went out from Egypt, who met you in the road and smote your rear, even those that were feeble behind you when you were faint and weary. Therefore it will be when the Lord your God will have given you rest from all your surrounding enemies, and the land which the Lord your God giveth you for an inheritance to possess it, that you will blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. You will not forget it. And the king who, and the king who will have pity on Amalek and upon his memory or upon his seed, behold, I will require it of him, and I will cut him off from among his people." And Moses wrote all these things in a book, and he enjoined the children of Israel respecting all these matters. The mighty hand of the Lord. And just look, when those children were out in the middle of the desert, and there was no food anywhere around them, the Lord fed them with manna from heaven. Do you think in these last days that he may preserve his children with manna from heaven? Wouldn't that be amazing? Or possibly what he did with Elijah and the widow and her son, that the oil and the flour never emptied, that it never went away. It stayed there every day, day by day, until the drought was ended with the rain. Our God, is there anything too hard for him? Have faith. Have faith that he's going to provide for us and care for us. And well, whether we're here in this world or the next, we're with him and he'll be with us. And then we'll be together forever and ever. Oh, can you imagine falling down at his feet, thanking him for everything that he's brought you through, for all that he did on the cross for us? Oh, guys, it's going to be wonderful. Hang on to that. You're going to need to hold that in your heart. And as always, I love you.